y'all. Welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to give you 3 tips on how to reverse iron deficiency anemia. I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knudsen, and I'm a certified holistic health coach, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related conditions using food as medicine. So if you're new to my channel and you like what you see, hit the subscribe button and don't forget to hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. Some of you are really suffering with iron deficiency, anemia, low iron. I've been there and I've overcome it. And I'm going to give you 3 tips on how you can overcome it too. So stay tuned, watch the whole video until the end because I'm going to share with you some information about supplements that might be able to help you. So first of all, healing iron deficiency, anemia, low iron is not just about taking supplements. It just really isn't. It's impossible just to throw iron at iron deficiency and make it go away. Ask yourself the question, how long have you been fighting iron deficiency? And you've been taking the iron pills and you've been going and getting the infusions or the blood transfusions. Has any of it worked? I would think not. Sometimes it improves for a little while, but then it goes back down. Just like, for example, if you get an iron infusion, a big dose of iron, like it will help you for a little while, but in a few months, you're right back in the same position that you were in from the get-go. So that's not how you heal the problem. In order to reverse iron deficiency anemia, you have to deal with the organs and glands that are associated with reproductive health. You've got to get those organs and glands working in the perfection in which God created them to work. But to name just a few of them, you've got your kidneys, your adrenals, your pituitary gland, your colon, and your liver. So those are the 5 that really need worked on in order to correct this whole situation. But I can't teach you all of that in a 5-minute video. So what I am going to do is to give you the 3 tips that will help you out tremendously. If you want the whole picture of how to heal your reproductive issues across the board, you may want to consider joining my 90-day Walk to Freedom from Fibroids group coaching program. The next one is going to be in January. If you're interested in learning more about that, the link will be in the description box below and up in the cards above. The first tip is that you have to attack one of the main culprits that is contributing to the heavy bleeding that is causing you to be anemic or have low iron in the first place, and that is what you put in your mouth. I know I'm always talking about it, y'all. Y'all are probably like, would you stop talking about this already? But it is, first of all, it's not the only issue, but it is the first thing that you can do to help alleviate some of the symptoms. So when you have practiced a diet and lifestyle that is primarily consisting of junky foods, processed foods, sugar-laden foods, not enough healthy foods, your body becomes toxic. And, you know, I'll talk to a lot of women and they'll say, well, I eat healthy and I'm still having heavy bleeding. Well, here's what I'm going to tell you about that. If you eat healthy and you still have heavy bleeding, then you might not be eating healthy enough for your particular body. So there's probably some things that you need to clean out of your diet in order to help alleviate the toxic waste that is in your body that is contributing to why you are bleeding too much, that's causing you to have low iron anemia or iron deficiency. The junky foods that we eat causes our bodies to get clogged up and toxic. And one of the channels of elimination in the body is the vagina for women. Men don't have a vagina, so they don't have that area of elimination, but women do. So when we have our period, what will happen when our body is trying to eliminate excess waste that it can't eliminate through other channels because they are all clogged up too, like the colon, the skin, the liver, the lungs, etc. What ends up happening is the uterus tries to purge toxins through the vagina through bleeding. And that's why you'll have like these episodes of hemorrhaging every month And it's because your body's trying to release toxins. And then in some cases, there are people who are just bleeding nonstop. I used to do that. My body used to just bleed nonstop. And I can tell you exactly why my body used to do is because one of the problems I had was I was constipated. I was constipated since I was a little kid. I can remember being like 4 or 5 years old and sitting on the toilet and waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting for something to happen, and it didn't. And I had always been like that my entire life. There would be some periods where I might go more than others, but I'm telling you, I was constipated. So my body was on overload as far as toxic waste. So no wonder I developed fibroids and acne and all kinds of toxic conditions. So that's just an example of why someone would be pushing blood out of their uterus in that way, is because your body's trying to get rid of toxic waste. And the first line of defense is by changing what you are putting in your body. So most of you know I created a foods to avoid list. If you don't have that list, you can get it in the description box below or up in the cards above. It's called the foods to avoid to help you shrink fibroids naturally. It's going to give you the basic foods that you should eliminate from your diet to help you in this process. But in general, what you would need to alleviate to give your body a break so that it can heal is meats, dairies, processed foods, sugar, grains, alcohol, caffeine. But if you download the ebook, it'll give you a little bit more detail as far as what you should avoid. So if you eliminate the foods to avoid, that's going to help with your process of reversing anemia or low iron. So the second tip is eat your greens. Eat your greens as much as you possibly can. Right here, I have a green smoothie, and this smoothie is filled with Swiss chard. That's the green of choice in this particular smoothie. It tastes really good. I can't even taste the greens in this smoothie. It has a pineapple, banana, and Swiss chard. That's what's in this smoothie. And if you eat greens every day, you are feeding your body the chlorophyll that it needs to help replace your minerals and your iron in your body. The thing about the smoothie that's different than juice is that the smoothie has the fiber intact. If you prefer that, great, but you can drink green juices as well. But the thing about juices and smoothies is that if you do green juices and smoothies, I should say, you are going to give your body an infusion of greens that it needs to replace the minerals and the iron that your body has lost through the heavy bleeding. So I would do whatever I could to replace my greens. I would drink green smoothies or green juices or both. I would eat big salads. And also I did a what I eat in a day video that had a smoothie recipe and a salad recipe in it. And if you haven't seen that, I'll link that right here in the cards above and down below in the description box for you to see. But it'll give you some examples of what I mean by how many greens you should eat in a day to help replenish your iron stores and your mineral stores. But the next thing that I want to share with you about the greens is I also recommend to my clients to use liquid chlorophyll. And I will put a link below with the type of chlorophyll that I recommend my clients to use. It is a concentrated liquid chlorophyll. It is a really good quality liquid chlorophyll, and it's going to help you to replace the minerals in your body. So far we've talked about changing your diet, getting rid of the foods to avoid, and getting your greens in. And last but not least, there is one iron supplement that I absolutely love. I have had many of my clients come and say, hey, my iron level was an 8. And now it's a 12 after a few months. And that is fast for iron to increase that quickly. So I definitely recommend this one. And this one is the Mega Foods Blood Builder. I'll put a link down in the description box for you to go ahead and get that if you're interested in it. But one thing I want to say about the liquid chlorophyll as well as the blood builder, do not think for one second that you can just go out and buy these two blood, this blood builder and this iron supplement and say, I'm going to take it and expect miracles to happen and not do anything else about changing your diet. Because as long as you keep on doing things to yourself that contribute to the problem, you will never be able to reverse the problem. So a lot of us, we pray and ask God to help us to reverse these problems and everything. And we don't want to change our lifestyle. We don't want to stop doing the things that caused the problems in the first place. I don't think that you taking iron pills and liquid chlorophyll is going to do the thing that you want it to do. So I would say combine all three together, change your diet, drink the liquid chlorophyll, and take the iron supplement. And I think you will have good results. Now, there is more to the story around anemia. Like, I have not talked to you about the whole picture here, but you will be able to get some results by implementing these three steps into your life. Like I said in the beginning of the video, if you want the full picture of exact steps on how to heal naturally from these issues, consider joining my 90-day program in January. All right, y'all, I have shared with you three of my tips on how to reverse iron deficiency anemia. I hope this video has helped you. And until next time, I'll talk to y'all soon. Take care.